Hello guys, so this is day 4 of MIT App Inventor tutorials. So let's start this project. So click on Start New and say day 4. In this video, we will learn about checkbox, date picker, list view, lot of things. So here we go. So day 4, list and OK. So as you can see, that's the screen here. In the previous video, we have learned how we can use button, image, labels. And in this video, we will learn how we can use checkbox, date picker, list picker and list view. Okay, and I will show you the demo. We will create one simple app with the help of all these components. We will use your block coding also. Okay, so here we go. So let's drag and drop that checkbox first. Okay, so do you know what is the checkbox? Checkbox is the thing that we can use to get an input from users. Okay, so suppose we have some hobbies, okay, and we all have multiple hobbies, right? So what we can do, we can have multiple checkbox, okay, and we can say to the user like, please select your hobbies. So you can select more than one hobby using checkbox. Okay, so let me show you how we can do this. So first of all, let's connect this with emulator. So just connect an emulator. Let's open the emulator. So as you can see here, that's our app is started. And as you can see, this is the checkbox. Now you can just check this like this. You can uncheck this. Okay, so what I will do, I will create one simple app. Okay, where I will use multiple hobbies and I'll say that to the user, like, please select multiple hobbies and we will display their hobbies in the label. Okay, so how we can do this? So I will just click on this checkbox and change the font size to 18. Okay, or maybe the 20, I think. Right. And what I will do here, I will just change the text. So it's like cricket. Okay, that's one hobby, and make it font bold like this. And I should try this to 30 or something. Let's see, this is 30, it is updating here. Okay, and I will just remove the bold font from here like this. Cool. And I will just copy, okay, this copy cricket, control C or control V or command C or command V like this. And I'll just say here singing and here dancing. Okay, and just say one more, reading book, and one more is coding. Okay, so here is coding. Now I will display, whenever someone select all these hobbies, so I have to display that hobby in one label. Okay, so first I will use here one label here like this, and make sure we should use the layouts to proper design your app. Okay, so I will use your layout. So layout, and I will use your vertical layout, and I will make all this in a width and height is fill parent like this, and I will move all these components here like this. Okay, under that layout like this, and here this is our level one, and I will make all these in a center like this, in a center. Okay, align, this should be center, not vertical, it should be top, but I think this is not look good. So what I will do, I will make that in the left. Okay, so it will cool. And in the label text, I will just change, please select. Okay, now what I will do, I will just change the font size to 30, please select something. Okay, and what I will do here, whenever someone selects some hobbies, so I will display all these hobbies in one label. So I will again drag and drop one label, okay, like this, and I say your hobbies, and I will change the font size to 20 something. Okay, so now what I will do, I'll just please select hobby like this. Okay, now what I will do here, I will add one thing, let me just make it 26 or something. Cool. So let me just check that first, how it will look. Yeah, please select hobby. Okay, so as you can see, we can select the hobbies like cricket, singing and dancing like this. Okay, but I have to display that hobby in here after label, your hobbies like this. Okay, so how we can do this? So what I will do here, I will use here one button. So after submitting this hobbies, okay, submit, on click on submit of that button, I will change the color of that button. After submit, I have to display my hobby here, your hobbies on that. Okay, so how we can do this? So for that, we have to use your block coding, right? So let's code the block first. Okay, and whenever, just click on that button here. So once the people click on this, okay, so I have to display hobby. So what I will do, I will use your join text. Okay, as you can see, left side, a lot of properties like text. Okay, so how we can use text? So click on this. As you can see, the join. Okay, this is the for the normal text and this is for join. Okay, so just use this join. Okay, so what this will do, this will combine the two strings. Okay, this will combine two strings. Okay, so we have to combine, we have to add that string in the label. In which label? In that your hobby label. So what I will do, I will use here one layout, and that is horizontal arrangement, and I will make this with this fill parent, and I will add that hobby here, and I will add one more, this one text, and I will remove the text from here. This is level 3, where I will display all my hobbies. Okay, I will make this 13 or 14 like this. Now we have to combine all these hobbies. Okay, so how we can do this? Let's go to the block, and what I need to do, we need to display hobby in the level 3. Okay, so set level 3 dot text, this one. So once the people click on this, so we have to display the label. So let me show you one example. So if I suppose display one simple text here, okay, like this, hello. Okay, let's refresh this. Let's try, let's click on the submit. As you can see, hello here, right? Let me just make it the sizer, big size is something 20, you can see, and submit button is also 20 something. So as you can see, once I click on that button, submit button, so we can see one text. Okay, so see, like hello. But what I need to do, whenever I select some multiple hobbies and once I click on submit, so I need to get all these hobbies that I have selected. Okay, I need all these hobby here. Okay, how can we do this? Go to the block. It's very simple. Now let's click on control, and as you can see here, if and then. Okay, it means if something is correct, if something is true or right, then we have to perform that action after then action. Okay, it means when we have to perform this overall block, on the button click, it means here. After the button click, it means once the user click on that button, so we have to perform action. So if means what? Okay, so if means we have to check condition. So in the left side, you'll find checkbox. So as you can see here, checkbox fun dot checked. So if I will use here, so what does this mean? If checkbox one dot checked, okay, if this is checked, then you have to add level 3 dot text value to checkbox one dot checkbox one dot text, this one. Cool, let me just show you how this will work. Refresh this, and here, suppose if I will check this one, it means first one. What will happen? So submit, this should display the cricket. If I will uncheck this, and let's submit, okay, I have to refresh this again because we have to add clear button also. So it's again done. If I will uncheck this, I'm not checking this. Okay, so click on this submit. As you can see, nothing here. Okay, so we need to add condition in multiple. So multiple, it means in all the checkbox. How we can do this? Simple, just copy paste if and then. So I will use 5 if and then. Okay, simple, 3, 4, and 5. Okay, we will in the further tutorials, we will learn how we can use if else and how we can use loop. It's a very simple way to use if else. Okay, if and then. So as you can see, checkbox checked, then this checkbox 2 dot checked, then 2, checkbox 3 dot text, then this 3, and checkbox 4 dot text, where is checkbox 4 dot text, then checked, then checkbox 4 dot text. Now as you can see here, checkbox 5, I can display only one, right? I can't display the multiple, right? So what should I have to do to display the multiple hobbies on button click? Okay, so let me just refresh this. Let me show you what I'm talking about. As you can see, if I will select cricket and dancing, so I have to display here that app should be display cricket and dancing, submit. But as you can see, I can see only dancing, not cricket. Why? Because this one is replaced, this 3 is replaced the first one. Okay, so how we can join all of them? So do this, we have one join function. As you can see, this join. Okay, so I will call this join here, and I will use checkbox here, and which text we have to join? We have to join previous text. And which one is previous text? previous text is level 3. So level 3 dot text, this one. Cool. So same thing we have to do for all. So it's simple. So I will just add it here like this. So I need to change that to 2. Then again I have to add. Done. Now let's try this, how this will work. Okay, so suppose let's refresh this. Let's see, select 1, cricket and dancing and coding, and let's submit. As you can see, cricket, dancing, coding, this showing, but I need a comma here between this. So what I will do, I will add one more join. I need to add one more join for that. Okay, so what, how we can do this? So it's simple. I need to add one join in the between a string like this here. Okay, so how we can do this? So it's simple. I need to use a text, and I can use here one separated comma or something like this. Okay, so I need to do it for all again. What I will do, I'll just refresh this and let's see how this will work. What I will do, I will just select only last one too. Okay, it means reading and coding. Let's submit this. As you can see, reading, book, okay, and dash, comma, sorry, comma, and coding. Cool. If I will select singing, and then, so this will display again the all of it. Let me just refresh this, because this will combine the again the same thing also again. That's why. So let me just refresh this, and let's try to add all the hobbies, check, and submit. As you can see, the comma and all hobbies. So that's the amazing use of checkbox. So there are a lot of ways you can use checkbox. You can use checkbox to select hobbies. You can use checkbox to calculate the bill. There are a lot of ways. Okay. So as you can see here, there's one more component is date picker. So date picker is mainly used for to select the date. Okay. It's really very simple. Let me show you how this will use. We can use this. So as you can see, click on this. And you will display, we will display here this text. Suppose if you want to add the date of birth of your user, okay, something, so you can use date picker. So they can select the date. So we will display that date in some label. So I will use here one label like this. And once I select the date, I have to display that, date in label 4. So go to the block. So once the people click on select, as you can see, date picker select. And as you can see, the after date set. Okay, after date set, I need to display that date in the label. And which label? Level 4. So level 4 dot text. This one. And click on again date picker. And you will find the properties, like you will find that this thing is, as you can see, the day, year, and then day, year, and month. So I need to combine this. I need to use again the join function like this. And I will use here, I need to use comma or something here to separate the, you know, date and this thing. So I'll just use date picker and go here and just select the day. And then again, use one text, normal text here like this. Okay, let's just go here. And I need to use here comma or something slash like this. And I'll just copy paste this. For again, and I need one more to here like this. For the second, I'll use the month. Where is month? This month, and is like year. Cool. And I need to display here slash in this. Okay, so let's refresh this. Let's see how this will work. Once the people select this, so select this. And I will set the 2023 21st March. So I will just 20 March and 25. Or if you want to display it, you know, date of birth, you can choose anything and just okay. And as you can see, 23rd and 2017. See, so that's the amazing use of checkbox and date picker. Okay, so now if you have any doubt, you can ask me on comment. If you want to add any suggestion on this series, so just comment on the video. I try my best to solve problems. So thank you so much for watching this video. Please subscribe my channel, like this video, and share this video. Have a nice day. Be safe. Bye bye.